Hello everybody, good morning. I am Pradeepta Kumar. Welcome to today's session. So guys, this is the tutorial number 43 of AWS Cloud Tutorial Series. On today's session, we'll discuss about one properties or features of S3, that is cross-region replication, known as CRR. So in today's session, we'll discuss how do I add a cross-region replication rule to an S3 bucket. So guys, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now for more videos related to different cloud technology, different DevOps tool, VMware administration, Linux administration, and many more latest technology. So guys, before going with the lab session, just I want to give our view on cross-region replication. So what is cross-region replication? So if you can see guys, that in this diagram, that's one bucket has been created in West one region, and another bucket has been created in UU-West2 region. Okay, so one bucket is in North California and another bucket is in London. Okay, there is two different region. So and cross region replication has been enabled. So if I will enable the cross region replication, so if I will put some contents or object in one bucket, so it will be replicated to the another bucket which is in different region. Okay, so a destination bucket can be in the same AWS account as the source bucket, or it can be in different account. Okay, if the destination bucket in a different account from the source bucket, and you must add a bucket policy. That means we need to create a IAM rule for that. Okay, so guys, this much I know. This is the overview of CRR, and now we'll go for the lab session. So guys, I have already logged into the my management console of AWS. So I will click on services. So I will go to S3. So guys, okay. So in S3, I have created two buckets. Okay. So one bucket is in US West Oregon region. Another bucket is in US East region. Okay. So I will copy. This is my source bucket and this is my destination bucket. Between will enable the cross region replication, so that if I will put any object in source bucket, so it should be replicated to a different bucket in different region. Okay, so simply I will select, I will copy the source bucket name. So this is my source bucket name, and I will copy the bucket name from the destination bucket name, copy here. And okay, so this is my source bucket and this is my source bucket name. Okay, so what we will do, I'll select, click on my source bucket, then I'll go to management, then go to replication, then click on add rule. Okay, so guys, before enabling the replication, so we need to enable the versioning on both the bucket. The versioning needs to be enabled on both source bucket as well as the destinations. Though I have not enabled, so it is asking me to enable. So click on enable versioning. So this is the prerequisite. So you want to do the replication for entire bucket or any specific object. So I want to go with the entire bucket. I want to enable replication for entire bucket. So I selected. Then replication criteria. If you want to if you want to establish the communication with a CRI encrypted manner, so you can replicate object encrypted with AWS KMS. So I'm not going to use. Okay, as per US you can use also. I'll click on next. Then it is asking me destination bucket. What is my destination bucket? So what is the destination bucket? So this is my destination bucket. I'll copy. And it is asking bucket in this account or bucket in another account, because in my case the I am using the same account only. So the bucket is not in the different account. So I will go with the bucket in this account only. Just paste. Then we need to choose the region. Okay. Because that bucket is in US East region, right? On North Virginia. Okay. Select it. Okay. So it is saying that the bucket doesn't have versioning enabled. So I have already told you. So we need to enable both versioning in the source as well as the destination. So click on enable versioning. Then it is asking us to destination option, storage class you need to choose. Okay, it is optional only, you can choose or else you can ignore also. So I will click on next. Then we need to create a rule for that. Suppose I will give my test rule. Okay, then disable or enable. Okay, select a rule or select a rule. So that means I am giving the, you know, there is my test rule, then I will click with the create new rule, and my rule name is my test rule. Okay, then next. Okay, so you can see this is the review page. Bucket name is my test. This is the source bucket information and destination bucket. Source bucket is my test Oregon, destination bucket is my test bucket to North Virginia. So one bucket is North Virginia region, another bucket is Oregon region. Okay, so this is the rule name. Next. Okay, so rule got that means replication, it is saying the replication configuration updated successfully. So now we'll go with the testing. Okay, so I will click on Amazon S3, then this is my source bucket, right? So I will click, so there is no there is no object here also, there is no object. Okay, so that means there is no content, so fully empty. So I will click on my source bucket, so I will try to upload. Okay, so what I will do, add file, then my policy PDF. Okay, so medipolicy.pdf, so click on upload. Okay, so just refresh this. So now the object got uploaded. So let me check, we uploaded in our source bucket, so whether it is replicated to another bucket or not. So this is our destination bucket. I will click here, so I will put US, this is in North Virginia, so I will replace it. See, the same content replicated to another bucket. So guys, in this way you can enable the versioning as well as the CRR. So hope you enjoy the session. Please stay tuned for next videos. Thank you very much.